Reading books can be such an amazing experience where we can see things from new perspectives, learn new concepts, and enrich our minds. If you're looking for a way to read more actively and keep track of all of your books, quotes, and have a central space for your reading journaling, I wanted to share with you the Book Library and Reading Journal Notion template. This has been one of the first templates created by the Organized Notebook, and I'm excited to share the latest updated version with charts, more features, and an overall improved design. I'll also show you the AI-powered and standard version depending on your needs. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first start with a brief overview of this template. When you first open it up, you'll see a reading dashboard where you can see your reading now, your books that you want to read, and books you want to read again. Underneath the reading dashboard, we have reading lists, so you can keep track of things like reading goals, book lists, book club lists, and all of your completed ones will be shown here. So you can do things like have a challenge where you have different kinds of goal books, and then you can see your progress. Then we have browse by genre. So as you can see, we have one book in fiction here. And if you open it up, you can see all of the books in this genre. So you can keep track of all of your books this way as well. On the left-hand side, we have a mood photo as well as a quote that you can customize, and then there are quick add buttons for adding new books, journals, author, genre, and quote. And then we have a navigation that's centralized, so you can always return home and go to the various different pages of this template. Underneath the navigation, we have browse by author, so you can see a list of your favorite authors. And then we have the databases, which I recommend not to delete or the template won't work anymore. Then we have our reading journal calendar here. So every day you can see your reading journal and stay motivated to journal every day. And then on the right hand side, we have a list of your quotes up here. And then we have all of the books based on status as well as by rating, and then finished and view all. Next, let's go over how you would use this template. So the first thing I would just recommend you to do is start adding books. So to add a book, you can click the plus new book button here, or you can just simply click into your reading now if it's a book that you're currently reading. And if it's a book that you want to read, you can just click here and add new books. So I'm going to go ahead and use this quick add button to add a new book. The first book that I'm going to add here is one of my favorite books, which is Atomic Habits by James Clear. And once you have the title, you can start by adding a cover photo. So I'm going to go ahead and add cover, change cover, and I'm going to add a link to the cover photo. It's really easy to find links for book covers if you go to your Google image search, and then I'm going to go ahead and submit that link here. Now I can add the statuses. So if this book is something I want to read, reading currently, finished, or want to read again, I'm going to put it into reading now. So it's going to be in reading. The genre for Atomic Habits is going to be self-improvement. And then for authors, I'm going to need to create a new author. To create a new author, I can just simply type into here, James Clear, if it doesn't exist already, and I'll just create one like this. Then the format, so I have the paperback version, so I'm going to add that like this. And then you can add the dates that you're reading this book. If I'm going to start on July 3rd, I can just add that date here. The next part is reflection. So if you want to keep track of whether or not you've reflected about the book, then this checkbox can be super useful. So I'm going to leave this unchecked because I have read it yet, as well as the rating since I haven't read it yet. Then we have some key info. You can add things like the publication date, a book URL, and you can also track your progress. So for the progress, it's dependent on the book length and the current bookmark. So the book length is 320 pages. I'm going to add 320. Let's say that I'm at 100 pages in, then you'll see that I'm at 31% progress. The hours read is actually calculated based on your reading journal, which I'll go over a bit later. So you can track how many hours you've been reading if you want to really track that every day. Then we have the ownership. So the ownership means whether or not you own the book, whether you've loaned it out, whether you've borrowed the book, sold, donated, subscription, lost, or if it's on your wish list. I'm going to put that I have it owned. And then you can also add ownership notes. So if it was gifted by someone, you can also note that down. If you want to know where it's located in your house, so if I put located in my living room bookshelf, you can do something like this. If it's something that you've loaned out or you've borrowed, for example, from the library, then you can add a return date here so you can keep track of overdue books. The next thing is going to be reading goals and favorite quotes. These are connected to the reading list. So if you have reading challenges, book club list, you can tag that here. And you can also see your favorite quotes up here. Then we have a very basic note section where you can just take very brief notes if you need to. And then we have everything inside. So the daily reading journal is going to be based on book. If you're reading this book and you want to journal about it, it's going to end up here. You can add quotes directly in here. And then you can also do your reflection with these prompts as well as add a summary. So once you're done filling it out, I'm going to click out. And now if I go to reading now, I'll see Atomic Habits here with my reading progress percentage. So that would be my first step to add a book. And if you want to add it based on a genre, you can also just click here to add a new book, and it's already going to be tagged self-improvement like this. The next thing I wanted to cover is if a genre doesn't exist for a book, then you can either click here to add a new genre, or you can add the genre as you're adding the book. Let's say that I'm going to add a new book here. The genre doesn't exist here, so I can click type sample genre and then simply create a new genre like this. When I create a new genre and I go back to my main page by clicking return home, I'm going to see that new genre here. And if I open that up, you'll see that I have all my books for that genre already. So that's that book that I already added. And I can fill it in by adding also a cover photo as well as an icon to get started. All of your genres are also located in Browse by Genre. So if you only want to see your genres, you can look at it this way. And with the genres, you can also see all of your books and see what percentage of your books are in different genres. You can see that 66.7% of my books are in self-improvement. So this can just be a fun way to track what kind of reading you like and what kind of books you have. So now if I go home, the next thing I wanted to cover is the reading journal. So if I click reading journal, I can go to the dedicated reading journal page. And let's say that I want to journal today, then I can just click into my reading journal here, and it's going to load already my reading reflection. I can choose what I read. So I read Atomic Habits, and the minutes I read, let's say I read for 60 minutes and I read 60 pages. So then if I click out, you can see 60 pages, 60 minutes, I read Atomic Habits. And this month you can see a chart here. So the more I add, you'll see a graph that's going to start showing up here. So let's say that I read on this day Atomic Habits and I read 30 minutes and 30 pages, then you'll see that I have a graph starting to show up. You can see it by minutes read and pages read. And you can also see it by month. So you can see an average minutes read and an average pages read, as well as a feed view if you want to see your daily reading reflections. And if I go home, now if I go to my Atomic Habits book, you can see the reading journal populated here as well. And you can also see how many hours you've read so far with this book. The next thing I wanted to go over is the author gallery. So I just added James Clear through the book. But now what we can do is to click this open and fill James Clear's author page completely. So that means we can add a cover photo, change cover. And again, I can add a link to his picture. And then I can add in his birthday, his country. And then you can see I have one book by him, and also I'll see your average rating. So the more books that I rate, the more I can see an average rating of each author. So I can see which authors I really like. You can see your authors by country. You can see your authors as a list, and you can also see books that have no author, so you can remember to tag them correctly by the author. Next, let's go over to favorite quotes. So here you can add new quotes depending on the book. So let's say that I want to add this quote by James Clear, Habits Are the Compound Interest of Self-Improvement. And this is in Atomic Habits. I can add the page number and a category like this. Then I can see my quotes by category as well. And if I return home and I go to my Atomic Habits, I can see all of my quotes here. And I can also see the quotes listed here. If I want to quick add a quote, I can also just click plus new quote, choose the book, and then quickly add them in as I'm on the go. And the next thing I wanted to go over is the reading lists. So the reading lists are also reading challenges, any kind of book club lists, and so on. So if I click reading list here, I can start by adding a reading goal. So let's say that I have a new reading list. I want to read motivational books list, and that's my reading challenge. Let's say that I'm going to start here, and then I have a goal date. So in 2 or a month or so, I'm going to finish this list. So now I can add Atomic Habits as one of the books. I can add a summary of the goal, a link to that list if I'd like. I can mark if it's completed. So now I see my books here. When I'm finished with this book, it's actually going to update the progress of my reading list. So this way you can categorize your books based on different kinds of topics or challenges or book clubs. And I've already gone over browse by genre, so I'm going to next go to all books. So in all books, you'll see every single book you have in your book library template, and you'll see it by the current status, by rating, whether or not you finished it, by format, and a view all. And then here we can see a donut chart based on whether or not what the status is, by the ratings you have, and then the ownership. So if you click on one of these, you can also see what kind of books are related to that. So that's also a really nice feature. And then we have the inventory. So here you can keep track of all of your library books, for example, if you have any books you've loaned out, books on your wish list, subscription, lost, donated, or sold, and by ownership. So just to showcase how that would work, let's say that the Atomic Habits book is actually loaned out. So that means that I've loaned it out to, let's say I loaned it, and if I click it open, I can decide that Kelly is supposed to give it back to me on the 24th. So now I can see that in the next 30 days I have this. Once Kelly has returned this to me, I can clear this date and I can mark this as owned again, and then it's going to be back in my library. And similarly, if I borrow it from the library, I can click the borrowed here and I can put public library and then put the return date here that I'm supposed to return it on the 31st. And then if I go here, I can see that I've borrowed Atomic Habits. You can also add it to wish list and all of these simply by selecting the correct option that you have. So now if I return home, the final thing I wanted to go over is what to do when you finish a book. So let's say that I finished Atomic Habits. So I'm going to put 320 pages. So I'm 100% done. I've completed my reflection. So I can go ahead and reflect on that, put a rating, and then I'm going to change the status to finished. So there is an automation built into this template so that when you finished it, it's going to add one to the times read. So you can also keep track of how many times you've been reading a book, which makes it really flexible. And you can also organize your book list based on how many times you've read it as well. So now it goes into my finished list, which you can go to all books, and then you'll see finished here to see that you've finished it. And if you'd like to edit this template more for your own needs, maybe you have very specific things that you want to track, you can always add more properties to your book database. So the best places to add things are here. You can add plus add a property. You can add things that are really important to you, like when you bought the book, all of these really custom things you can just add inside of here as you need. You can also go to the customized layout if you really want to go deeper into customization. Next, I wanted to go over the premium plus AI version of this template. You do need to have AI access in your workspace to be able to use these features. But the additional features with the AI version of the template is first inside of each of your books in your book library. So if I go ahead and add a new book in here, so you can see that here, reflection prompts and reading comprehension, you can generate these questions here so that you can get some nice ideas on what to reflect about and what to answer for the reading comprehension. Then we also have an AI summary here that you can click to update. So let's say that this one is about Atomic, and I added a reflection here. So if I do something like this, and then I go ahead and click here to update that, then it's going to showcase a summary that based on what I've written inside of the page. The next way that you'll see AI inside of this template is if I go to my favorite quotes. So now if I open up a quote, I can also access AI through the quote reflection. So it's going to give me 5 journal prompts that could help reflect on the book quote, and I can just simply generate that. And I can see some questions here that I can write about. And then another place that I think is really fun with this AI feature is the reading suggestions. So here you can click get a suggestion. And if I type something in here, let's say I'm looking for an adventure book. I want it to be in the mountains and I want it to be a classic. And then I click here, update. Then it's going to give me some options on various books that I could read. So I like this feature that if you're stuck on what to read next, you can use this reading suggestion generator to add all of the qualities of the book you're looking for and then generate. And finally, if you're just looking for a really simple way to keep track of a reading or you want to customize everything yourself, then the Book Library Standard version might be right for you. This one is a bit more simplified version. You can add simple reading goals up top. You can see your reading now, want to read books, as well as have a rating. And then you can see all of your genres below and all of the books. So it's a very simple experience. There's only one page in this template as well, so you can easily use it and get started with it. Thank you so much for watching. The link to the template is in the description below. If you have already purchased this template in the past, the upgrade is free. More details below. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.